Is your municipality aiming for net zero? Then let's talk about community and recreational buildings. Municipalities across Canada provide valuable recreational and community services to residents and must find equilibrium between levels of service and the cost of maintenance and operations while dealing with an aging municipal building stock. Buildings are a significant source of greenhouse gas emissions in Canada, and many municipalities have made net zero commitments by 2050 or earlier. But we also know that 70% of the buildings that will be standing in 2050 are already built. That means that, for buildings, the Net Zero by 2050 challenge is a retrofitting challenge. If you are a municipality, you are most likely already building an asset management plan. Why not integrate climate considerations into it? The Community Buildings Retrofit Initiative from the Green Municipal Fund helps municipalities overcome this challenge. And to do this, we've adopted a greenhouse gas reduction pathway approach. So, what is a greenhouse gas reduction pathway approach for buildings? Well, it involves a sequence of measures that allow buildings, in this case, local, recreational, and cultural facilities, to achieve a 50% reduction in greenhouse gas emissions within the first 10 years, and an 80% reduction within 20 years. Each pathway is unique, but they all start with the need for accurate data and a detailed plan. Take, for example, the fictional town of Greenville. Greenville City Council adopted a motion declaring that the city must achieve drastic greenhouse gas reductions by 2040. They applied for and received support through a building monitoring and analysis grant, allowing them to collect and analyze relevant data. Greenville built on the results of that work immediately through building recommissioning, meaning they tweaked and optimized their building systems, which led to considerable cost savings and greenhouse gas reductions, what we call sometimes the low-hanging fruit. They then received support for a feasibility study to examine how they can bring emissions from their portfolio of municipal buildings down to net zero. And what did this show? It showed how they can align planned maintenance with greenhouse gas reduction goals to optimize the impact on level of service, cost, and the environment. The study showed that they would need to take a few steps on their pathway to net zero. In year one, they would make critical building upgrades, like putting in new insulation, changing their old windows for new energy-efficient models, greatly improving the building envelope and leading to some pretty impressive energy and greenhouse gas reduction wins. In year five, they would begin some high rate of return measures, such as installing a heat recovery system for their ice rink refrigeration system. In year 10, as systems are near replacement age, they would begin replacing their HVAC systems with new energy-efficient models. They would switch from gas-fueled equipment to electric heat pumps to connect to their province's rapidly decarbonizing electric grid. And finally, in year 15, they would install solar photovoltaic panels on many of their buildings to strive for net zero. This ensures the best use of municipal finances since equipment is replaced at its end of life. This ensures long-term financial planning and allows municipalities to even reinvest the cost savings into future net zero upgrades. The Green Municipal Fund is there to support municipalities along the pathway to net zero. So, are you ready? It's time to take the next step towards realizing your community's energy and climate goals.